So good. And one thing I loved about this is that not once in the movie was she ever referred to as Wonder Woman, which is true to the original lore, where she was dubbed Wonder Woman by everyone else, but she never once called herself that. And I love that, because she never wanted to be famous. She never wanted to be this big hero. She just wanted to help mankind, to help make the world a better place. But everyone else dubbed her Wonder Woman, so she kind of went with it. But she never actually called herself that. And I love how in the entirety of the movie, we never once had anyone refer to her as Wonder Woman. I loved that. That was a little off topic. Hell, this whole video's been a little off topic. But, so I'm really excited about that. Like, she was just so good. She was so... And now, we get to a scene that I honestly, the entire movie was dreading. So we get, you know, the night has fallen, the front has moved forward, the village is saved, Diana did a good thing, she's fantastic. And so her and Steve dance. And I love how they didn't even, like, try and be like, Steve was gonna teach her how to dance because she didn't know. She's like, of course we have dancing on Themyscira. Like, of course we do, you know. And then she even, like, kind of, it's like, what they're doing is not dancing. They're just kind of swaying. And I like that a lot, because not once did they portray Diana as less intelligent because she didn't understand the world of men. If anything, they portrayed her as more intelligent because of what she'd been able to learn on Themyscira. I loved also the conclusion that men are necessary for procreation, but when it comes to pleasure, unnecessary. That's all. Oh, that was so good. I'm just like, well, definitely know a woman put that line in the movie. Just saying. And of course, Steve's just like bumbling, no, that's not. And she's like, okay, good night. Like, anyway, back to what I was saying. You know, the scene, I literally was dreading it the whole movie because I was like, ugh, we're gonna get a gratuitous sex scene and all this. But we didn't. Like, and so they're dancing, and of course, you know, Diana's like asking questions because she's still really curious about the culture. Even though they're in the middle of a war zone, she's still curious about the world of men, you know, outside of Themyscira, something she's never seen or understood or been a part of before. Anyway, so I'm thinking, you know, I'm thinking, okay, you know, they're gonna end up going back up to the room and, you know, they're gonna, you know. But then it didn't happen, where they go up to the room. Also, the precious reaction of Diana to snow. And this was a huge, I loved what Chris Pine did to this, where she's literally like, oh my god, it's magical! And he's just like, yeah, but it's that totally cliched where he ain't looking at the snow, he's looking at her. It's like, okay, Steve, okay, you're precious, I like you. Where, and you just see that, like, Chris Pine did an excellent job in portraying how in awe of Diana he was. Like, it was so good. But anyway, so they go back up to the room, Diana walks in, and you can tell Steve's kind of like, do I leave, do I stay? Do I leave, do I stay? I want to stay, but do I stay? Like, you can see that indecision on his face, but then he turns around, and Diana gives him the most smoldering look of smolder. Like, oh boy. Just, someone needs to, like, gif that, and that just needs to become a gif. Also, there's that gif out there that's saying, it's like from SNL or something like that, where it's just like, I'm both scared and aroused. They totally played that with Samir, and that was really funny. I am both terrified and aroused. Like, it was so cute. Anyway, back to the scene. And then, we get it where This is the thing that blew my mind too, is like they get closer together and Diana's the one that goes in for the kiss, not Steve. Diana's the one that goes in, and then we leave. We don't see anything else. For all we know, they just went to bed and cuddled. I mean, probably not. Come on. I mean, as Steve said, he has to have some virility. But, I mean, I don't know. Probably not, honestly. Like, but we don't see it. And that makes me so happy. I can't even verbally explain why that makes me so happy, but it makes me so happy that they didn't show it. And then we just go next morning, everything's normal, everything's cool, whatever. It was so good, guys. So good. I don't know how many times in this video I've actually said that, but probably two. One second, guys. I think I hear the munchkin call me. I'll be right back. Give me one second. I'll be right back. Sorry about that, guys. I could have swore I heard her calling me, but she's actually passed out right now, so. Guess I was just hearing things. Anyway, what was I saying? Oh, yeah, the scene that I was utterly dreading that actually ended up being really cute, and I loved it. Because I have nothing, honestly, in the original Wonder Woman with Linda Carter, I shipped the hell out of Captain Trevor and Diana. Like, they had really good chemistry. So I'm a fan of the ship. Like, just because I'm gay doesn't mean that I hate all heterosexual relationships. I don't. It just takes a lot more for it to interest me. And this one definitely interested me because it was played so well. So, let's see, what happens next? The gala. Oh, the gala. I love how, like, Diana's just, like, goes off on her own, finds that chick, and she's, like, literally sizing her up. Like, literally, being like, that'll fit. And just walks in, which, another thing is, Steve, he was this close to getting Moreau to talk to him. This close! Because he's a damn good spy, and I loved that they didn't make him this, you know, dumb punch first, ask questions later. They didn't demean his character to make Diana better. Diana was just fucking awesome, but he was too. Like, because that's a huge thing that I see in film nowadays, is where they'll have, for one character to be better, they kind of have to, like, tone down the other characters to make them even better, to kind of, like, raise them up. And they didn't do that at all in this movie, where every character had their good points and their bad points. And they didn't play down the bad points to make the good points better. It was, ugh. That's a really attractive face. Anyway. That's one thing I absolutely loved about it, was that they didn't play down the fact that Steve Trevor was a fucking amazing spy, and he was good at what he did. But then, of course, Diana's gotta saunter in and be all like, look at me, I'm fucking hot. And he's just like, and I forget what I'm doing. Oh, God, you're so sexy. And I'm like, dude, Steve. Same, Steve. Like, so good. And then the sword in the back of her dress. I'm like, I get it. I do. Like, that's, I mean, and that answers the age-old question when someone, they're at, like, a gala or something, where, like, and suddenly, like, pull a gun out or they pull up a knife or a sword or something. They're like, where the fuck were you keeping that? We know where Diana was keeping hers. We don't have to ask that question. It was in the back of her dress. You know, and then Ludendorff, like, the whole scene with Ludendorff where he's, like, just being like, blah, blah, it's a good thing, blah, 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 which I'm like, okay. And then, of course, Steve's stopping her and Diana's line of, you don't get a say in what I do or whatever it was, and I'm just like, so good. Well, and then, of course, we have the village, which is super heartbreaking, but I love how Diana runs out of the village and Steve's like, you know, maybe they're, you know, is trying, and she's mad at Steve because she thinks that Steve stopped her from killing Aries, and if she had killed Aries, then they wouldn't have shot the missile, which means they wouldn't have killed the village. And so she's mad at him, but the moment Chief starts sending up those smoke signals, Steve does not hesitate to tell her where Ludendorff is. He does not even hesitate. He immediately goes, follow the smoke signals, that's where Ludendorff is. Because as much as he doubts that Diana's right, that killing Aries can end the war, he still does believe in her. Maybe not fully. Maybe not like 100% like ride or die, you know, I'm going to throw every... And that's one thing I loved about Steve, was that he had his mission and his plan to end the war. He had his mission, he knew what he was going to do, and Diana's mission was a little different, but he never stopped, except for when he literally, like, physically stopped her from killing Ludendorff, he never stood in the way of her mission for the sake of his, except for that once. And honestly, I'm with Steve on that one. Her, like, pulling out a sword and shish kebabbing Ludendorff in the middle of a gala would have just made things worse. Because then it would have been seen as an assassination attempt, and they would have probably connected her somehow back to Steve, and Steve back to the British, back to the Americans, and would have just... there would not have been a possibility for an armistice for probably a few more years. Had she done that. So I'm totally with Steve on this, but I also understand Diana's point of view, where she doesn't understand the politics behind war. Which is very evident when she was yelling at the general, being like, fuck you, the generals fight and die with their warriors, you should be ashamed, you're a horrible person. Like, you can understand, she doesn't understand the politics of mankind's war. And the Amazons, when they fought, they fought in a time where there was no politics to it. You go out, you fight the war, you win the war, whoever wins, wins. Whoever comes out alive, wins. You know, that's how wars were back when the Amazons were fighting wars. You know, in World War I and the wars that followed, it was a lot more political, where you had to do things a particular way, you know, stuff like that. And I love how, like I said, Steve had his mission, Diana had hers, and they never stood in the way of each other's missions except that once. And then the moment Steve had an opportunity to try and get her to back off of her mission in favor of his, he didn't take it. He didn't take it. He said, okay, well, there's Ludendorff. Go do your mission. And she did. Which was so cool. Like, oh man, it was just so cool. But, ugh. And then of course we get her actually fighting Ludendorff, which was super cool, especially because she kind of learned to project her, whoa, guys, do you feel, oh god, ah!
No.
Huh. Sorry about that, guys, that was, apparently we get earthquakes in Oklahoma now, that was, huh. Oh boy, it even messed up my computer and everything, like that was crazy. What was I talking about? Ludendorff. So, she actually, like, learned to deflect the bullets, so she destroyed his gun. And honestly, I will admit, at the beginning of the movie, when Moreau first gave him the little tablet things, I thought Ludendorff was Ares. But I was supposed to. Though I will admit, I pegged that son of a bitch from the first time he was on screen. Lupin, you've been up to some weird shit. I don't know, it's just something about him, when they first introduced him on screen, I pegged him, as not necessarily as Ares, but I pegged him as a bad guy. I don't know why, I just got a vibe off of him where I'm like, he's not a good guy. Like, he's trying too hard to be a good guy. Like, I think that's what it was, where I just like, he's trying too hard to be a good guy. Like, he's not who you think he is, and you can even ask my mom. I leaned over to her after the pub scene. I was like, he's not a good guy. We're supposed to think he's a good guy, but he's not a good guy. I totally pegged it. That was me. It was awesome.
Actually, you said you didn't like him from the get-go.
Yeah,
very first scene, it's like, there's something up with him. He's not good.
I didn't like... It's like, especially when he saw Diana, it wasn't just a man going, there's a woman in the council chamber stuttering. It was, oh, fuck, stuttering. Like, there's a difference. Which I guess just kind of leads you to the fact that the guy, I don't know his name, I'm really sorry, but Lupin, the guy who played Aries, his acting. Because you could tell the difference. It was not a, there's a woman in here stuttering. It was, oh, fuck. Like, there was a difference. And I pegged him immediately as someone I didn't like. But I didn't necessarily peg him as Aries. Though, as the movie went on, I started doubting that Ludendorff was Aries because he was too obvious. He was way too obvious as Aries. So, and that's when, like, in my mind, I was going like, I bet you it's Lupin. And it was. I was right. I even guessed it before my dad did. My dad, right before, like, the final battle with Ludendorff, leaned over me and be like, it's the woman, it's Moreau, she's Aries. And I was like, I was just sitting there with this big old grin on my face. I was like, nope, you wrong. And then as soon as he popped up in the back and, like, appeared, my dad's like, oh my gosh, I was wrong. And I was like, it's pretty good. It's pretty excited. I don't often figure things out before my dad does. So I was pretty excited about that. Anyway, but then the whole thing where she was using the lasso of truth on Ares and somehow he was manipulating it was so cool. But even then, Diana didn't let herself be led astray. She was like, no. I mean, even after, like, killing Ludendorff and seeing this, you know, and seeing that the war continued even with Ares dead, and I loved Trevor's talk where he's trying to convince her to help him anyway, because he's like, look, okay, so maybe killing this one guy is like, I love him. He's like, you know, I wish I could just tell you there's one bad guy, and if you kill the one bad guy, everything else is fine, but that's just not how it is. And I love that. And I love the, you know, it's not about deserve. It's about what you believe. I love it so very much. And Steve Trevor, it's like Steve Rogers all over again. Stay away from planes. If your name is Steve, do not get in a plane in a war zone. It's not okay.
Especially if you plan on being the yellow one left on the plane.
It's just a bad deal. But, and then Diana was so badass. Oh, God. She's so badass. And Aries, especially because I love how he's, like, trying to be like, yes, they're all horrible, they're all evil, even your Steve Trevor. And she's like, fuck you say? Like, just goes, like, she's taking care of all the Nazis, and then he says that, and she's like, bitch. Like, can't you see I'm emotional? Like, oh, it's so good. It's so good. Oh, I love it.
I love it when she's holding the tank up.
Oh, yeah, where she's literally just holding the tank like it's nothing. She's just like, what do I do? And then her line, you know, it's not about deserve. It's about what you believe. And I believe in love. Throw a tank. Like, and I know I've seen where people have said that's cheesy. And it's like, really, the whole plot of the movie is that love saves the day. And I was like, you know what? Because it fucking does. Like, that is one thing about humanity and about people is our unbelievable capacity to love that is just mind-boggling, where we can love so much. And I love, like, that's the kind of message we need nowadays. We don't need these dark, gritty messages about where, you know, no one's truly good or no one's 100%. We need that, where we have this character, Wonder Woman, who, yes, she's now become quite a bit more worldly. She's definitely become someone who understands that people are not inherently good. But she still gives them the chance because she knows that love is something that mankind did right. So, with that, I just want to say, Patty Jenkins, all the awards, all of the everything, because I never realized how badly I needed a movie, especially a movie like, there's a freaking gnat. A movie like this, a superhero movie that was directed by a woman. Like, I didn't realize how, no matter what movie it was, Thor, the other, you know, like I said, your Thor, Iron Man, the other Marvel movies, even Superman vs. Batman, movies that were directed by men, I have to kind of... This is the first ever time I've got to see a movie like this and actually watched it, and it felt like I was watching it through my own eyes. I've always felt like I had to kind of, in a way, watch it through... I was watching it through someone else's eyes. I was watching someone else's interpretation of the events. But this one I got to see through my own eyes, and that is... I didn't even know I needed it until I got it. And that is unbelievable for me. You know, so, Patty, you know, get to work on that sequel. And the only request I have for the sequel is, give Wonder Woman a girlfriend. I would be totally okay with that. Like, can that be a thing, please? Alright, well, I think I've yammered on enough. This is like, I said, this whole after review will be split up into probably 3 or 4 smaller videos, just because, like I said, I rambled quite a bit, but as you could tell, there was not even an iota of this movie that I did not love. And that's saying a lot. Usually I at least have a few things about movies that I'm not entirely okay with, but this one was good. So good, guys. If you haven't seen it, go see it. Please. Go see it in theaters. Which, honestly, if you haven't seen it, why did you watch this? I literally just ruined the whole movie. But if you've seen it, if you haven't seen it and you watch this and you're like, maybe I should go see that movie, go see it. It's completely different from my rambling to actually getting to see the majesty that it is on screen.
Go see it again!
If you've already seen it, go see it again. Because we want this movie to be successful, because then that'll actually, you know, give Hollywood a message that if they actually make movies that are meant for women, we will go see it. They will still make their money. They might even make more money, because we're tired. We are tired of the same male-driven, male-led, male-directed movies. We're tired of it. You know, we want something different. And I'm not saying that all movies with male leads are bad. They're not. I mean, heck, some of the Marvel movies I really, really like. You know? But that doesn't necessarily mean that we just want something different. So, on that note, I will see you guys in the next one. Say goodbye to Diana. Bye, Diana. You're so pretty. Okay. I'll see you guys next time. Bye!